Hi everyone, we're ready for a second lesson that has to do with queuing up visual clues. These things help students pay more attention to Hebrew print, to the words, and in this case, it's all going to be about syllables. And I give you a warning, I'm probably going to blow your mind. Every time I present this in a workshop, I'd say at least a third of the people have their backs up and they go, oh no, that can't possibly be. And it's really hard for them to accept. But according to a mentor of many of us, Dr. Lifsa Schachter, who's the one who brought us Hebrew through movement, the way we divide syllables in Hebrew is very different from the way we do it in English. And all I do is ask that you go with the flow on this one. So when I was in elementary school, I was told that to know the number of syllables in an English word, I just needed to clap. The number of times I clapped indicated the number of syllables. The word ball has one syllable. But the word English has two claps, so it has two syllables. But the Hebrew rules for dividing in syllables does not depend on claps. The number of bounces, if you will, we hear in a word is not how we determine syllables. Instead, what we do is we count the number of vowel signs, and there are three rules to know related to this. Number one, a vowel sign indicates a syllable. Everything you see up above is a full regular vowel sign. One vowel sign, one syllable. See if you can figure out what dots and dashes are missing from this list. I'm going to tell you again that if it's not in this picture on this page, it is not a vowel sign. But let me explain in a moment. The word lakum has two vowel signs and therefore it has two syllables. The second rule you need to know is that a shva is not a vowel sign. It does not denote a syllable. Forget shva na, shva nach. It does not denote a syllable. In this case, in reality, a shva was originally placed in words to help the reader know not to look for a vowel sign. So this is not a syllable. And if you take a look at shema and count the number of vowel signs, you'll see only one vowel sign, the patach, one vowel sign, one syllable. So far we have two rules in play. Count the vowel signs, but do not count any shva that you see. Each of these are called a chataf kamatz, a chataf patach, and a chataf segol. These have a shorter vowel sign, a vowel, they're considered shorter vowels than a kamatz, a patach, and a segol. They are related to the shva. And guess what? A chataf, like the shva, is not counted as a vowel sign. So take a look at this word and see if you can figure out how many syllables are in it. Remember to count the vowel signs and ignore any shva or chataf. Pause this presentation while you think and count. So here we are again. Each syllable needs a vowel sign. There are three of them. One, two, three. So there are three syllables. Note that the syllables and the way we do this in Hebrew actually helps with pronunciation. An American might normally say, thinking about English syllables, avotenu. A more authentic Israeli accent would say avotenu. And you can hear the avo kind of blurring together. That's a syllable. So let's practice. Here are six words. Pause the video, figure out how many syllables there are. Do not forget the three rules that I gave you. So check your answers. How well did you do on this one? But hang on to your device because I'm about to blow your mind if it wasn't blown already. Let's take a look at this word, which is tough. It stops kids in their tracks because it looks like it has, oh, I don't know, we'll call it 10 syllables. It's long. but pause the video and actually count the number of vowel signs to determine the number of syllables this word really has. So in the end, when we divide according to the Hebrew sense of syllables, we're able to chunk long words like this into more manageable ways of looking at it and decoding. And again, it helps us with pronunciation. An American accent might say, b-mish-mi-ro-te-hem. But if we have our kids understand that these are four syllables and we want them to read each syllable as a whole, they're going to stop and go, b-mish-mi-ro-te-hem. B-mish-mi-ro-te-hem is how a more authentic, I'm not an authentic Israeli by any means, but you get a more authentic accent out of that. So the question is, how can you help students learn how to work with Hebrew syllables? First step, explain what I just explained to you. There's no clapping, but there are three rules that they need to know. Then divide students into small groups and share the same word for each of them to analyze. How many syllables does each pair of students agree are in that particular word? When a group has completed its counting, a representative from each comes up to your board and writes the number of syllables that that particular group agreed to, 3, 4, whatever it is. If everyone has the same answer, and the answer is correct, then you're good to go and move on. But if their answers are not the same, then you need to ask each group to explain how it came up with its number. Take the entire group through the three rules again, with everyone coming to agreement on the correct answer. And just in case there was any doubt, lefanecha has three syllables. Repeat this with one word that everyone works on in their small group. Double check. At this point, everyone should be coming up pretty much with the same answer with the same reasons. Then give each group a set of identical words cut into cards. It's a great job for madrichim. Ask each team to decide how many syllables there are for each word and put them into piles by syllable. So all the one syllable words are going to be in one pile, all the two syllable words in another pile, the three syllable words in a third pile, and so on. And then ask a representative from each group to write how many words they have under each of the, for each of the syllables. So they might write something like this. Group one, for instance, says they have 3-word cards that have one syllable, 4-word cards that have 2 syllables, 6-word cards that have 3 syllables, and so on. But notice when you look at this, not everyone is the same. So what you want to do is have your students go back, renegotiate their numbers, and put their new set of numbers on the board, and then hopefully everyone has come up with the same response. And if not, you're going to have to go through and figure out as they're working where their challenges are and then work through it again. Don't do this just once. You should repeat the activity the next few times you meet and then again in the future. When individual students have trouble with their reading, you now actually have a new strategy. You can ask them to stop and divide the word into syllables. You can do this idea of dividing into syllables, without ever having students decode out loud or read out loud. What it does is get students to focus on the micro, on the letters and the vowel signs, and that will improve their decoding and reading. So we'd love to hear how things are going for you and your students. Post on the Facebook page, Onward Hebrew. Post on the page where you found these modules. There's some places where you can tell us how things are, what your challenges are. We'd love to hear, and we'd love to have you help other teachers who are just beginning this process along the way.